welcome to this session. We'll be looking at problems and solutions for union, intersection, and complement, and we'll mostly be using Venn diagrams for that. When we looked at Venn diagrams in the previous session, we had three different varieties where we had overlapping sets. A and B overlap with each other, and this is the common elements area. And here we have A contained within B, and A and B are actually contained within U. So set contains another set. And we had the disjoint sets which have no common elements. Now here in this case we say A is not a subset of B because all elements of A are not part of B. Here A is a proper subset of B because A is contained within B. And B is a proper superset of A. Here too, A is not a subset of B and B is not a subset of A. Okay. Now when we looked at union of sets, we said it is combining the or joining the elements of all given sets. So we had three different diagrams to represent that. In each diagram, the shaded portion shows the union or the combined elements of sets A and B. Okay. So A union B is actually written as A, the symbol U like symbol, and B, and we say X is such that X is an element of A or X is an element of B. Okay. Now here you can say the symbol U is for union. That's the way to remember it. For this particular diagram, A union B is B. Okay. Because A is already contained within B. So the union gives us every element of B. Now intersection of sets, we said we have to find the common elements between the given sets. For that too, we looked at three different types of diagrams, and we said once again the shaded portion gives us the intersection or the common elements. A intersection B is written as A, the N like symbol, and B, and we say X is an element such that X belongs to A and X belongs to B. N is for the intersection. Okay. Now here A intersection B is A itself because the commonality between A and B is the set A or the elements of set A. And in this case, because there are no common elements, A intersection B is an empty set. For complement, we looked at what is called as the absolute complement, or let's call it as complement. Elements that are not in A. So if this is set U and this is A, the shaded portion here gives us the complement of A, and it can be written as A prime, A to the power of C, or A with a bar on top of it. Any of these represents complement of A. A complement is X such that X does not belong to A. Now relative complements, we have two types, elements in A that are not in B. So this shaded portion gives us A minus B, and we say X is such that X belongs to A, X does not belong to B. Similarly, we have elements in B not in A, the other way around, and this shaded portion gives us B minus A, where X belongs to B and X does not belong to A. Now that we have looked at all the basic details, let's get started with the problems. The shaded region in the following diagram is, so what are the options we have? One is A intersection B, A union B, A prime, and we are given four different options. Let's go over them. Now the shaded portion here, what does it represent for A and B? It is the common portion. So is that A intersection B? Yes, it is, because A intersection gives us the common area. So this is the correct option. If A is oceans of the world and B is oceans bordering North America, which Venn diagram below shows the relation of these sets? Okay, we have three different options here. Now, when we look at these two sets A and B, what do we notice? Oceans of North America is a proper subset of oceans of the world because it's contained in oceans of the world. Or we can say oceans of North America are part of oceans of the world. Now, the first diagram, what does it show? That oceans of the world and oceans of North America have something in common, but not all. So, this is not the correct option. When we look at option 2, we notice that oceans of the North America seem to be part of oceans of the world. So, we have one circle within another. So, obviously, this is the correct answer. This cannot be the right answer because these two have nothing in common and they are disjoint sets, whereas these oceans are not disjoint sets. Okay. Which Venn diagram shows the relationship between birds, parrots and swans? Let's look at the options we are given. We are given four different options. Now, birds, parrots and swans, what do they have in common? Parrots and swans are both birds, we know that. But actually, parrots and swans themselves are not related to each other. Now, when we look at option 1, it says the three sets are such that one is contained in the other and both of them are contained in the third one. Here we are saying parrots and swans are not related, so this is not the correct option. Second one shows that the two smaller sets are actually not related. However, they are showing that swans and parrots are partly birds and partly not birds. So, this is also not the correct option. Now, the third option shows that either parrots or swans, only one of them is part of birds, the other one is not birds. This is also not the correct option. Now, the last one shows, hey, both parrots and swans are part of birds, but they are not related to each other. So, option 4 is the correct answer. Draw a Venn diagram to show the relationship of the following sets. We have set of natural numbers less than 8, prime numbers less than 8 and even prime numbers. Set of natural numbers less than 8 is 1 through 7. Let's call this as U. Set of prime numbers less than 8 is 2, 3, 5 and 7. Remember, 1 is not a prime number. Let's call this as set A. Set of even prime numbers, we have only one even prime number. Okay. And let's call this as set B. Now, how do we draw the diagram? Let's say this is our set U. We notice that elements of B are contained in A. So, because B has only one element and it's part of A, all elements of B are in A and A has more. So, B is contained in A and elements of A and B are both contained in U, right? So, this is a universal set anyway. So, we draw the two circles. So, here B is a proper subset of A and these two are proper subsets of U. So, B is contained within A. Let's go with the elements and put them in the Venn diagram. When we start with element 1, it's only part of U. It's not part of A and B, this element. Now, when you come to element 2, it's part of U, A and B, all three of them. So, where should it go? It should go into B because B is already contained in A. So, 2 will be part of A and it will also be part of U. Element 3 is in U and A. So, it goes here. Element 4 is in only U, so it goes outside the circles. 5 is in U and A, so it goes in here. 6 goes outside the circles. 7 is in U and A, so it goes here within A and outside of B. So, this is how you can write the elements of sets to show the relationships. Next question, draw a Venn diagram to show the relationship of the following sets. Set of whole numbers less than 10. A is set of multiples of 2 that are less than 10. B is multiples of 3 that are less than 10. Now, you remember it's a set of whole numbers and they start with 0 because they are less than 10, 0 through 9. A is multiples of 2, that means 2, 4, 6, 8, so on. But it must be less than 10. B is multiples of 3 that are less than 10. So, multiples of 3 are 3, 6 and 9. we cannot go to the next one because we want numbers less than 10. So these are our three sets. We are going to do the Venn diagram now. All elements of A and B are contained in U, right? U has 2, 4, 6, 8 and 3, 6, 9, all of these elements. Some elements of B are in A. So A and B only have some elements in common, not all. So A and B are not subsets of each other. So this is the overlapping circles we have drawn for A and B. Now 0 is only part of U. 1 is part of U. 2 is part of U and A. So it goes here. 3 is part of only U and B. So it goes in this circle. 4 is part of U and A. So it goes here. 5 is part of only U, so it goes outside the circle. 6 again, U, A and B, all three of them, so it goes into this common area for A and B and U. Okay. 7 is only part of U. 8 is part of U and A, so it goes into this circle. 9 is part of U and B, so it goes into this circle. Okay. Next question, select the options that are applicable to the diagram shown below. What are the options? We have 1, 2, 3 and 4. Now for all of these, we need to know what A complement is. Okay. A is students in the 10th grade. So what could A complement be? It is something that is not part of A. So it is this shaded portion. Now A union A prime. Or A complement. A union A complement, is that giving us a set U? Yes, it is. Okay, so first option, it is true. Second option, A complement is students not in the 10th grade. If A is students in the 10th grade, A complement is students not in the 10th grade. So that's also true. Now option 3, we are saying A intersection A complement. A intersection A complement. Do these two sets have anything in common? One is saying students in 10th grade. One says students not in 10th grade. They have nothing in common. So it's an empty set. Is it all of the above? Yes, that is true. So all of these are true for the given diagram. Next question. Given U equal to toys in a box and the diagram below, select the correct option that has the complement of A. We are going to see which option gives us complement of A. We have option 1, 2, 3 and 4. Now once again, set A is electronic toys. So what is A complement here? It's this shaded portion. Now let's look at the first option. It says toys that are not in the box. If U is toys in the box, can we say A complement is not in the box? Set of toys that are not in the box. That means it has to be outside of the rectangle, which is not true. So that is not the correct option. Second option says toys that are not electronic and not in the box. Anything is that's not in the box cannot be A complement. It is still part of U. So this is also not the correct option. Third option says toys that are not electronic. Okay. A is electronic toys. So A complement is toys that are not electronic. That sounds right. Correct? Doesn't it sound right? Yes, it is. So that is the correct option amongst the given ones. None of the above is not true. Okay. Students in a class signed up for two games as follows. Tennis, Anita, Mihir, Meena and so on. Basketball is J, Meena, April, Anita and Nona. Use a Venn diagram to show students who signed up for both games, students who signed up for basketball only. Now to find out who signed up for both games, we see tennis and basketball. Both games means what are the names common between tennis and basketball? Who signed up for both games here? One is Anita. Another one is Meena. So where do we put them in this diagram? This is the common area. So Anita and Meena go in there. Second question, students who signed up for basketball only. Now, that diagram we have here, what do we want? Only basketball, and it should not be common to tennis. Common to tennis is Anita and Meena. Okay. So, when it goes to basketball, if you remove Meena and Anita, what are the names left over? We have Jay, April, and Nona. So, these three students signed up for only basketball. We have three different sets here. All bread, cheese, lettuce, so on. Use a Venn diagram to show the relationship between these sets and find A minus B and the complement of A. Now, like once again, we are doing the Venn diagram here. Sets A and B. Let's go over each element in U. Bread is common to all three sets, so it goes in here. Cheese, is that common to U and B? Yes, it is, so we put it here. Lettuce, U and A, goes in here. Tomato, common to, not common to A and B, so it goes only into U. Onion is common to U and A and also B, so it goes into this part. Mustard is outside the circles. Now, let's see how to find A minus B. What is A minus B? It is this part which is not common to B but has only A. And what is the element in that? Lettuce. So, A minus B is lettuce. Now, A complement is elements that are not in A. They can be in B but they can't be in A. Let's see what all those elements are. One is cheese, which is not in A. Another one is tomato, which is only in U, and mustard. So, cheese, mustard, and tomato are part of A complement. Okay. Now, U is 1 through 10, A is 1 through 6, B is 2, 4, 6, 8, 9, C is 3, 5, 6, 7, 9. Use a Venn diagram to show the relationship between these sets and find A minus B union C. Now we have the Venn diagram here with these three circles to represent A, B, C. Let's go, I'm not going to go over each element and try to show you how to write these elements, but very quickly let's fit in the elements into this diagram. One is only in U and A. Two is in U, A and B. 3 is in U, A and C, 4 is in U, A and B, 5 is in U, A and C, 6 is in U, A, B and C, all of them. So, it goes in here. 7 is in C only and U, 8 is in U and B only, 9 is in U, B and C, so that's why it goes into here. 10 is not in A, B, C, so it's outside the circles. Now, what is A minus B? Okay, elements that are in A, not in B. What are the elements in A, not in B? We have only one element here, 3 and 5. We have three elements actually. Because these are all part of A, but they are not in B. So, we have 1, 3 and 5. Now, union C. A minus B, union C. So, we need to find, we need all the elements of A minus B and C to be combined together. But we don't want duplicates. So, let's write A minus B first, which gives us 1, 3, 5. Union C. What are the other elements in C? We have 6, 7. And 9. Okay. So, we write 6, 7, 9 in addition to 1, 3, 5. That gives us A minus B union C. A is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. B is 4, 5, 7, 8. C is 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. And D is 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. Let's do this last problem and wrap it up. Okay. Let's look at the first part of this. A union D intersection B union C. We are not going to do the Venn diagram for this, but we'll keep it very simple and wrap it up. Okay. Now, A union D. So, we want all elements of A and D, but no duplicates. So, let's write all the elements of A first. And what are the elements of D? 10 through 14, but these two have nothing in common. So we just add on all the elements of D. This gives us A union D. Now B union C. Let's write all the elements of B. What other elements does C have? 7 and 8 are common, so we are not going to write those elements. The rest of them are 9, 10 and 11. So this gives us B union C. Now the intersection of these means we want the elements common to these two sets. Let's see what's common between these two. We have 4, 5, 10 and 11. So we have 4 elements in common. So this whole thing is 4, 5, 10, 11. That's the set we get. Let's look at the second question here. A intersection B, intersection B intersection C. Wow, okay. A intersection B. What does this mean? We want the elements common between A and B. What are those elements? We have 4 and 5. Those are the only two common elements between A and B. Now B intersection C, what are the common elements between B and C? We have 7 and 8. So those are the only two elements. Now when we take the intersection of these two sets here, okay, because that's the symbol we have. Now what is common between these two sets? They have nothing in common. So this intersection gives us an empty set. Okay. So hope you enjoyed this session. Please do subscribe to the channel and let us know if you wish to see more and more problems similar to what you have seen in this session. Catch up with you in the next session. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.